Hi, my name is Luke. I'm the oldest child of the Morrison family. I was 19 when mom and dad died, right after I got accepted to teacher's college. I was then forced to give up studying to take care of my sibling.
Hi, my name is Matt Morrison, and I am the second eldest of my family. I am a farmer who hopes one day will become a biologist and take my scholarship to university. But since the death of my parents, I cannot go because we got separated, me, Boo, Kate, and Luke, because we cannot afford to live all together. So me and my brother, Luke, we had to earn some money to pay the bills and make sure our family would have enough needs to survive.
My name is Kate Morrison, and I'm the third child of the Morrison's family. I get along pretty well with my brother Matt, who's 17 years old. But Luke and I never really talked to each other. I like to take care of my little sister, Bo. And I was 7 years old when my childhood was ruined.
Lord, thank you for the meal you have set for us today, and especially for the really good news we have received.
That's good. Amen.
Amen.
What news?
Well, Luke got accepted to teacher's college.
Really? Congrats.
You're going to be a teacher?
Yes.
He's a really fortunate young man. Not a lot of people have the chance he has.
When and where are you going? In Toronto?
Yes, I'm going at the end of September.
Do you think you're gonna need a suit?
Well, I believe maybe more suitcase.
Yeah, you're right.
We should go to the city.
My world, it moves so fast today. The past, it seems so far away. And life, I can't breathe. And every time I've tried to be what someone else thought of me, so caught up.
Hi, can I speak to the oldest person in this room?
Yeah, you can come in.
Thank you.
So, what are you guys telling me?
It's a tough news, but your parents died in a car crash.
Are you sure?
Yeah, they got hit by a truck.
And I'm made up my mind to define.
Father, I got something to tell you.
My own destiny.
The officer said that her parents died this morning in a car crash.
I'm Annie Morrison. I'm the aunt of Bo, Kate, Luke, and Matt. I'm the sister of their father, and after their parents died, I'm the one helping them.
Hi guys, I'm so sorry I took so long to arrive. The city is so big. Oh my god, Kate, look at you. You look so much like your mother. And this must be Bo?
Yeah, it is.
So, here we are. What time is it?
It's 4 o'clock.
Oh, really? So I think we should start with the cleaning, the washing, and all that of that stuff. I mean, I see you've managed pretty well, but I think we could do better.
Shouldn't we talk about more important stuff?
Yeah, you're right, but don't you think we should get to know a little bit more each other before? You're gonna have to talk with your father's lawyer before.
I guess we could do that instead. Thank you for your help.
Then came the worst moment of my life after my parents did. Annie asked us to come and sit down in the living room, which we did, all but Luke, who stood looking out of the window at the lake. She sat very straight in her chair and told us the following. That from the lawyer's office she had made a number of phone calls to the rest of the family, and it had been agreed that Luke should go to college as planned. It would use up most of the money, but everyone felt that it was what her parents would have wanted. Then, when it came to the rest of us, Ear and Annie, for all her straight back, had some difficulty. She looked away, then looked back. When it came to the rest of us, unfortunately, none of the various branches of the family was in a position to take on 3 extra children. Indeed, financial circumstances were such that none of them could afford to take on even 2. Therefore, in order to keep at least Bo and I together, it had been decided that if Matt were willing, he would go back with her to the farm. He would be an asset there, and the money he earned would go towards supporting his sisters. Yeah, that was the plan for us, and I hated that plan.
Kid, do you know who that is?
Yes, that's Miss Carrington, my teacher.
Whoa, she seems pretty young to be a teacher. Do you like her?
Miss Carrington is the only teacher in Craw Lake. She is very young and nice and has taught all the children except Bo. In part one, Miss Carrington tries to influence Math to go to college because she believes he's the smartest kid she has ever taught. Her sayings are a big part of a conflict between the kids.
She's pretty nice.
Mm. I understand you're Kate's teacher. I'm
yes,
Annie Morrison.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, Kate.
Hi. So, would you like a cup of tea?
Yeah, that would be nice.
Can you make a cup of tea for us, please?
Yeah.
I have some things to discuss with Miss Carrington.
No problem.
Thank you. I guess you came here for more than a cup of tea, right? What is it you have to tell me?
Listen, I realize it's none of my business, but I have to tell you something about Matt. Well, you see, all of these kids are really intelligent, but he's more than that. He's the cleverest child I've ever known. And he's only has 1 year of high school left.
Well, 2 years actually, he's 17.
I know that, but he skipped a grade. You see, he's only 1 year behind Luke. Next year, he'll take his exams and certainly will win a scholarship for university. I'm sure of that.
Thank you. So that scholarship, is it gonna cover everything?
Well, no, but still, I mean, it would cover all the tuition fees. I'm sure that you could figure out a way to pay for the rest. I'm really sorry, but I really need you to understand this. It means a lot to me.
But Miss Carrington, you have to understand there's a bigger problem in this family. If we could afford it, we would help him, but we can't. His father was in so much debt, and so is my family right now. We can't afford it.
But there's got to be a way. You could at least let him finish high school. I mean, at least that's what he deserves.
There is no future for them, not even on the farm. So you can feel bad about Matt not attending to university, but I think he's pretty lucky to have more education than most of them.
It's a real tragedy.
The past, it seems so far away, and life squeezes so tight that I can't breathe.
Luke prepares himself to go to the city to meet with the notary to learn more about our financial situation. However, he did not tell anyone he was going, so he leaves in the middle of the night, not making any noises.
Where have you been?
I was in town to see Dad's art.
Why?
I was thinking about staying with the family in Crow Lake and giving up teaching so that you could go to college.
You're giving up teaching?
I didn't even want to be a teacher, and you're better at school than me, so it's logic that you go.
What are you mad? That's a really great thing for the family.
Yeah, okay. And I really don't want us to be separate. It's a great thing.
Come on, man, think about it.
Kate, this is not right. How would you feel if I was leading you a place to university?
It's not just about you, it's about all of us.
You don't know how hard it is to bring up a family. You cannot work and take care of the family at the same time. It's a full-time job. It's going to be too hard for you.